The Billy Bragg experts, the more I play these songs, the more often I play them, the better I get at it. So, in theory, it may be infinitesimal. It may be almost a quantum size improvement in this song tomorrow night, but fuck it. There's lots of room for improvement in my guitar style, as you probably already noticed. Watch out now, Sparks like.
Got to go. and battles. We fight just the battle. You show about to lose. You fight just the battle to lose. You fight just the battle. You fight just the battle. You fight just the battle. You show about to lose. You fight just the battle to lose.
Transgender and non-binary community. See if they need a bit of allyship. So I'll tell you what I did. And out on the road, there I was out on the road in the UK singing the new tweet version. And I inadvertently summoned up a Twitter storm. Very angry, angry trans people. And I'm like, what the fuck is going on here? But the most interesting tweet during that tour was from a young trans person who said, because you know, the audience has reacted in the way you reacted there to me telling them that I've changed it. This young person tweeted, incredible to see such vocal support for trans rights among an audience that came of age in the 1980s. And they're saying something about us there. One, that we're cool because we've gone for it, but they're also saying how they see us. Those of us who in our youth were radical, those of us in our youth who were out there campaigning against nuclear disarmament, campaigning for Aboriginal rights, you know, with the miners, whatever it was we were doing, they see us now as kind of drifted away. And there is, in my audience, a demographic who really don't get trans rights, don't get what it's about. And to, I'll describe them in the kindest way possible, I can think of, which is geezers my age. Geezers my age. They're not quite got, you know, it's one of those things where they say to you, and someone did say to this man, I'm not sure it's my fight, Bill. I'm like, mate, imagine if we had said that in religious racism. Come on, just think about what you're doing. Because, you know, guys, this is, I don't want to upset you, but I have to tell you, we're never going to be pretty again. That is gone. Even with that charming smile. And you know what else? We're never going to be hip again. That's gone too. But there's absolutely no reason why, with a little bit of thought, a little bit of understanding, a little bit of engagement, we shouldn't be as relevant as we were back in the day when we were our true trouble. Yeah. With that in mind, I want to dedicate this with respect to you. It's called Mid-Century Modern. Have mercy on us, Father, who live through this age of storms. We barely have the time to bind the wounds caused by our shattered hearts. The credulous are on crusade against reality. Freedom's just another word for acting with impunity. Hard to get your bearings in a world that doesn't care. Positions hard to climb a gold field, comfy as an old armchair. But the kids that tear the statues down, they challenge me to see the gap between the man I am and the man I wanna be. This argument blew up again last night. Only one of us is wrong, but both of us feel in the right. My indignation drove me to say things that I regret. I hurt the one I love the most with my self-righteous temperament. Now I must face the consequence of the thoughtlessness I've shown. It wasn't my intention to spend this evening all alone. The wounded pride is all I have to keep me company. The gap between the man I am and the man I wanna be. Now I'm used to people listening to what I have to say. So I find it hard to think that it might help if I just stepped away.
and adjusted my perception to reflect reality. And the gap between the man I am and the man I wanna be.